Now I gotta do it again because of that stutter. Pelted with an apple when you select him. It's because apples are death. See, apple away keeps the doctor away, but an apple a day also keeps the kid away because it murders him. And I really don't think an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Because I'm always getting pestered by doctors, even when I eat apples. It's a dangerous world out there. Be careful about doctors. I mean, you did jump again, but you just hadn't hit the wall yet. It's not over there, is he?
We don't know that until we get there.
I'm relatively confident. The really almost impossible to complete Pokemon card set has a shiny Lucario in it.
Huh. He's yellow.
I think Yulu is cuter.
Yulu's me. Why do you keep jumping so high? Jump lower.
I really like that there's an Alolan Ninetales that doesn't require any energy for its attack. And its attack is Rubbish Blizzard.
Rubbish.
It actually would work really, really, really well with,
That was kind of terrible looking, but I still got Day Plus, so... Watch. Watch this ending.
You did it. Shin has a deck called the Rotom Motor Deck, which has zero energy cards in it. And he's won matches with it. Oh, it's a glitch, girl. No!
What does the glitch girl do again?
Takes you to the glitch bonus level in the world. But, his Rotom Motor Deck has no energy in it. It functions based off of there's an ability in one set where Rotom gets, basically infinite energy as long as there's a certain number of tools in your discard pile. And, the Alolan Ninetales also uses the number of tools that are in your discard pile increases the damage of the attack that doesn't require energy. So it's actually perfect for that deck and a different type.
Saying Shin's going to improve that weird deck of things.
No, because he said that it didn't make any sense since it's not a Rotom.
That doesn't make any sense.
Because the other thing is you could have an Alolan Vulpix, because there is an Alolan Vulpix that doesn't require energy as well.
Looks like they're trying to put me through the meat grinder.
By the way, that other one where you found Glitch Girl is probably the easiest place to try and get Glitch Girl, but it's easier to get Glitch Girl when you cleared all the other levels in the world.
Oh, I love this stage.
I know you do. I can tell. Look how much of your blood you painted all over it.
Time to fly, Wrench. What game is Fly Wrench even from?
Fly Wrench.
Oh. See, that sounds like the type of thing that should be obvious. No, really, who put all these saw blades here?
Gary.
They're all like, you know what hell needs? More saw blades. And someone's like, yeah! And they took, filled hell with all the saw blades. Just all of them. Nowhere else in the world has saw blades anymore. Hell took them all.
Flyrinch is an action video game developed and published by Messhoff. The game puts the player in control of 6802, a spacecraft floating through the solar system in search of a mysterious access point. It has a 9 out of 10.
Huh. Poor Flyrinch.
It's a game where, if I remember correctly, part of the trick is you have to switch which color you are based on the, like, types of lights that are nearby, and when you switch to those colors, they won't kill you, but if you're any other color than those bars, when they contact you, you die and you have to start the level over. It's got a 9 out of 10 on Steam.
Huh.
Rockhouse's favorite types of models.
Why?
He just really likes silhouette style things. I've noticed it from the numerous times that he's played Mario ROM hacks, when there are levels where Mario is all in black and all the things are in black and it's solid colors, so he's really like those. It's very like, well, it really reminds me of the Spirit or Sin City movies. The one accented color and everything else is black and white.
Feels very samurai to me.
Very samurai? Well, that's just because it's red and white and therefore it kind of looks like those stylized two different things that everyone knows.
Yeah, I know that.
I'm glad you do, because I don't know what I'm saying. The path these things go for is quite interesting. And very dangerous.
Let's fly. Let's get dangerous.
That's one of Izzy's favorite cartoons.
It is.
Izzy really likes the Disney ducks.
I do.
Like, a lot. He likes both the original and the remake of Duck movies. He likes,
Darkwing Duck.
Darkwing Duck. He likes the old Donald Duck cartoons.
Yes.
He likes the new Donald Duck cartoons.
I haven't seen it yet.
He likes... you read some of the Donald Duck comics, haven't you?
I have not.
Oh, yeah.
I would love to, but, I mean...
I don't think he liked Quack Pack.
Quack Pack was a lot.
It was very 90s extreme!
It was.
Also known as, it makes you feel uncomfortable with the type of language they use being so cringy. Man, that's bogus, dude. Okay.
And you know, they always have to have that one that's wearing the hat.
Yeah.
Preferably backwards.
Mm-hmm. Sunglasses are really popular. Everyone is color-coded. I mean, they were already color-coded, but everyone is color-coded.
Yeah.
It worked for the Power Rangers, it works for the Ducks, damn it.
It was the first time that the triplets had separate personalities.
Have you ever beaten the DuckTales game?
Nope.
I know it's difficult. And everybody really likes the space music in it.
Mm-hmm. Me too.
Well, I would hope so. Aren't you part of everybody?
Sometime. Or rather, I would leave that as a dedicated maybe.
Oh yeah, there's a bandage up there.
Yeah, I just noticed it.
I just noticed you noticing it. From over here, it's far enough away to see that it's kind of tricky to suss out the details.
If they can hide it from me. But surely they can.
You've probably never even seen that movie.
No. What movie?
Airplane. Leslie Nielsen 80s comedy classic. It has a lot of deadpan humor.
I don't understand humor. I don't have a sense of humor.
It's so actually the exact type of humor I think you'd like. It is a lot of people playing things for serious that are very clearly jokes.
Yeah, it sounds about right.
Leslie Nielsen became known for. He was originally a very serious, like, drama actor in, like, the 60s. And then he was put in... Was Airplane the first film like that? His first comedy? No, it was the Naked Gun. Naked Gun, which is like a spoof on serious action movies done as a comedy. They hired Leslie Nielsen, but told him to play everything as if it's a very serious role. And basically, that was the idea, was for him to play it like he would play one of his dramas that he'd been in for a long time. And, but to have him say these things that just don't mesh with that type of delivery. And it made things really funny.
That makes sense.
I felt really cool dodge. I feel really bad about how I died there.
And the world is evenly balanced once again. Cool dodge, pathetic loss.